Understanding and Preventing Fluid Injection Injuries, presented by the International Fluid Power Society. A fluid injection injury is a pressure-caused insertion of fluid, such as paint, hydraulic fluid, etc., into the body. These injuries generally occur when servicing items such as paint guns, hydraulic systems, diesel injectors, and grease guns. A pressure above 35 psi can cause skin penetration and may result in a fluid injection injury. The following material provides statistical as well as medical information found in a report by the Department of Emergency Medicine, New York Methodist Hospital. In the workplace, grease, gasoline, and paint are common agents found under increased pressure. Less toxic pressurized agents include water, air, and low-volume animal vaccines. Hydraulic pumps can deliver these substances in the range of 2,000 to 15,000 PSI, with heavier materials usually requiring the greatest pressure. Grease guns operating at 5,000 to 10,000 PSI account for 57% of high-pressure injection injuries. Fluid materials such as paint, hydraulic fluid, gasoline, and turpentine account for 18% of these injuries. An additional 14% are caused by diesel fuel injectors, 2,000 to 12,000 PSI, injection into the hand, and typically occurs as the operator is trying to steady the jet with the free hand or when trying to clean a plugged nozzle. Fluid injection injuries are relatively rare, and as a result, many emergency responders are unfamiliar with the severity and proper procedure for managing these injuries. When there is a high-pressure injection of a liquid, there is usually only a minor sensation of discomfort on the part of the injured person. But what is actually happening out of sight is something called compartment syndrome. The injected material, even if it is water, fills the channels or compartments surrounding the nerves, tendons, and muscles, pinching off the supply of blood. This tissue immediately begins to weaken and will eventually die if not treated quickly and properly. Several factors contribute to the severity of the injury, including the material's inherent toxicity, the volume injected, and the location and pressure under which the substance is delivered. In addition, the time elapsed since being injected is a major factor in the severity of the injury and the end result. Prompt and proper medical attention is essential to successful treatment outcomes. Injection injuries caused by pressures greater than 7,000 PSI have been reported to have an amputation rate of 100%. The injury to the affected limb may appear benign even when massive subcutaneous tissue damage has occurred. Injection injuries involving toxic chemicals are potential surgical emergencies even if the affected limb has a benign appearance. The overall incidence of amputation for high-pressure injection injuries is about 48%. Patients who undergo proper medical treatment in less than 10 hours after the injury have a lower amputation rate. Physicians who fail to recognize the likely severity of the underlying injury may inadvertently send the patient home with pain medication and without the necessary surgical intervention. Be your own advocate. Ensure that the medical personnel treating you understands the importance of proper treatment. Overall, the statistical chance of an amputation after a high-pressure injection injury is 48%. If the liquid includes solvents, this rate increases up to 80%. If the pressure is above 7,000 psi, the rate approaches 100%. A concerning statistic is that the average time between the actual high-pressure injection and the time the injured person seeks medical help is 9 hours. Typically, the reason for the delay is that the injury may appear small and benign, and the injured person feels foolish about complaining. The chance of having an amputation approaches 100% if medical attention is not given within 10 hours from the time of the injury. Don't delay. Even if you suspect that you have a fluid injection injury, seek medical attention immediately. Warning. The following information shows graphic images of actual injection injuries and what was required to properly treat them. Some individuals may find these images disturbing. This injury appeared to be just a small puncture wound at the base of the index finger. The injured person went back to work and did not seek help until after his shift. By that time, the hand was throbbing and he had lost mobility and his fingers were getting numb. X-rays revealed the damage being done and the location of the injected fluid. The compartment syndrome had set in, and at this point, he was in danger of amputation. The surgeon successfully located the areas that would need to be excised, and then the work began. The various compartments had to be opened and drained, and the dead tissue removed. In this next instance, a paint spray gun had injected fluid into the left hand of an operator, but he waited 12 hours to seek help. An effort was made to drain the wounded area, but as you can see from the black middle finger, the tissue had started to become necrotic or to die. The effort continued, but after 48 hours, it became a matter of how much of the hand could be saved. What started out as a treatable injection injury ended up costing two fingers and an almost complete loss of function in the hand after all the dead or necrotic tissue was removed. In the world of fluid power, connectors and conductors, hoses, tubing, and fittings are a source of potential high-pressure injection injuries. Pinhole leaks, burst hoses, and incorrect assembly or disassembly account for many accidents and near accidents. Understanding the basic structure of a hydraulic hose and how and why leaks and bursts may occur will help prevent and protect against an accident or injury. A burst or pinhole leak in a hydraulic system can cause serious problems, including personal injury, fluid burns and injection, fires and explosions, electrical shock, and mechanical failure, especially for anything or anyone located within a 3-foot line of sight. So, how do we protect our personnel? There are some manufacturing solutions such as hose guards. However, IFPS is dedicated to providing education and training to increase safety awareness by means of this video, as well as safety cards, safety posters, and articles on safety. However, there is one more area of education that should be considered, and that's certification. One major hydraulic hose and fitting manufacturer has stated that, on any given day, somewhere on the planet, they have a lawyer in court because of a component failure. In almost every instance, the problem was the improper application or assembly of the hose. It was this kind of information that led major connector and conductor manufacturers to approach IFPS to produce a certification for covering the application and assembly of these components. This is now the IFPS Connector and Conductor Certification. Training for this certification is rigorous, but those who attain it will gain a level of competency and proficiency that will serve to protect them and those around them. In order to protect our personnel, we must educate them on the dangers of high-pressure fluids. There are several points that should be stressed. Always be sure pressure is relieved in the system before doing any service or repairs. Never search for leaks by placing a hand near the suspected area, even while wearing gloves. Ensure anyone assembling connectors and conductors are properly trained to prevent leaks and failures. And finally, we must educate our emergency responders on the proper method of handling a high-pressure injection injury. The International Fluid Power Society has crafted a safety card which is being sent to every member of our organization and is also available for purchase for a nominal fee. The card is wallet-sized and provides important information as to what to do in the event of an injection injury. Because immediate, local, and appropriate treatment is necessary, there is a space on the card for the individual to place the contact information of the best local medical facility that has the knowledge to properly treat the injury. The fact that members, employees, and employers will have this card will not only increase the opportunity for proper treatment, but will also increase the awareness of the danger. Hydraulic injection injuries can be very serious and even life-threatening, but also very preventable. There are several actions that can be taken to minimize the risk. Engineered solutions such as limiting access to within 1 meter or about 3 feet of pressure lines, routing hoses so they do not chafe, and providing line-of-sight sleeving. Educational solutions such as training on the potential dangers, proper lockout-tagout procedures, and certification so only qualified personnel actually assemble hose, tubes, and fittings. For more information on how you can keep yourself as well as your personnel safe, visit www.ifps.org/safety.